In the previous video, we went through the initial solving process that created the face robot animation rig for our zombie. In this video, we'll animate the face and start tuning it to smooth out the rough edges. Open the FR Part 3 Start scene, which picks up where we left off from the previous video, on the Act panel. At this point, you can create poses to test out how the face deforms. To do this, you select and move the animation controls that drive the different regions of the face. You can also select the animation controls from the Act panel. Use the key buttons below to set keys for these animation controls at different frames, and then use the pose buttons to save the current poses so that you can reuse them later. Another way to animate the head is by loading motion capture clips onto it. We'll cover this more extensively in a later video, but for now we'll use the available range of motion clip to get a preview of how our zombie head looks when it's animated. Click the Apply button next to the clip name to apply it to the face robot rig. As you scrub through the timeline, you may notice two things. First, our zombie head has been automatically subdivided so it looks smoother. This is a normal step that face robot takes if the model's resolution is not high enough to accommodate the loaded motion capture clip. Note that this smoothing applies only to the 3D view and won't be baked into the mesh. To revert back to the original unsmoothed look, first locate the head geometry node in the face robot hierarchy in the Explorer. A quick way to do this is to select the head model and then press F in the Explorer. Expand the head node's hierarchy and click the Geometry Approximation property icon to open it. If a message prompts you to make this property local, click Yes. In the Geometry Approximation property editor, click the Polygon Mesh tab and set the subdivision OGL level back to 0. The second thing you may notice as you scrub the timeline is that some of the poses don't look so good on our poor zombie. For example, parts of his teeth are poking through his skin, his eyelids are not properly covering his eyes, and some areas need tuning in the way they deform, especially around his mouth. While you could say that these malformations are part of what makes this rotting zombie so charming, the real reason why we're encountering these problems is because the motion capture clip we applied to our zombie was not created for him, but rather for another character with more exaggerated, caveman-like features. That being said, we can still use this clip to help us highlight problem areas where the skin deformation needs some fine tuning. The process of tuning a head after its initial solve is what adds that extra level of polish that really makes your facial animation work. So to start, click Tune to move on to Stage 6, the Tune panel. As we've seen in a previous video, Face Robot uses a soft tissue solver to deform the face. This solver is driven by two types of operators working together: the standard Softimage envelope operator and special Face Robot deform operators. If you take a closer look at the deform region's display, you'll notice that the mouth area, and more specifically the lips, are not covered. Why is that? Well, since the mouth has a more complex range of movements than the other areas of the face, it requires a separate mouth solver working alongside the head's soft tissue solver. In fact, when Face Robot evaluates the skin deformation order, the mouth solver always takes precedence over the soft tissue solver. So a good way to streamline the tuning process is by starting with the mouth area before you tackle anything else. On the Mouth tab of the Tune panel, click Paint Mouth Blending. This displays a weight map that shows where the influence of the mouth solver starts and stops. Ideally, the mouth solver should only cover the lips, the philtrum, which is the part between the upper lip and the nose, and some of the inside of the mouth. The weight map is a little too broad around the mouth, and the philtrum isn't fully weighted. So the first thing to do is make sure that the correct vertices are associated with the mouth area, or else we won't be able to weight them. Go into Point Mode, then select Tune Mouth and click the Select Mouth button under Mouth Clusters. This highlights all vertices that the Mouth Solver controls. Hold the Shift key while you select the vertices close to the nostrils, and then add them to the cluster by clicking the Cluster Plus button. Using the Cluster Minus button, you can remove vertices from the mouth cluster in a similar way, such as the ones higher up on the cheeks. Once you're done, you need to regenerate the mouth region before you can adjust its weight map. FaceRobot warns you that regenerating the mouth region deletes any mouth sculpts. Since we don't have any, you can click Yes. Now you can go back to the Paint Mouth Blending mode and update the mouth's weight map so it blends smoothly with the rest of the face. Hold the R key while dragging to change the brush size, and the E key to change the brush opacity. You can also press Ctrl W to access all the brush controls in the Brush Properties page. Since our zombie's face is symmetrical, we'll turn on Symmetry to save time. Paint with the left mouse button to add weight to the map, or paint with the right mouse button to remove weight. Hold the Alt key while you paint to smooth weights and create a gradual falloff between the mouth solver and the soft tissue solver. Now scrub through the timeline to see how the mouth blends with the rest of the face. When you're done, press the space bar to return to normal selection mode. Now that we've adjusted the general mouth area, let's focus on tuning the lips to ensure that they don't pass through the teeth. To test this, go to a frame that highlights the lip's position and select the 8 animation controls that are spread across the lips. If you prefer to use the Mini Act panel, you can toggle it by pressing F6. Move the animation controls back to force the lips to go through the teeth. Each slider in the teeth collision group corresponds to specific parts of the lips. Adjust these values to push the lips slightly away from the teeth. You can also define other settings, such as how the lips connect at the corners, and if you want them to curl in or out. Lastly, you could adjust the depth of the inner mouth in cases where the jaw opens really wide and the mouth cavity could pass through the face mesh. When you're done tuning this area, reset the animation controls. In the next video, we'll move on to tuning the envelope weights and deform regions of our zombie's face.